Welcome, everyone. We are the League of Ordinary Gentlemen, and to my left, we have...
Stephen Bueno.
Christian Cabrera.
Josh Hogar Hall.
You're on my right. I'm Cornel Montgomery.
Yeah.
How y'all doing today? How y'all doing today?
I'm fucking full.
Me too.
I realize I'm still wearing headphones. That's where I'm at
are
right now.
Are you listening to anything right now? With the fast beats? Or?
Nah, I'm just not.
I love water.
I'm going to take them off. I totally forgot I had them
on. Are they just ear warmers?
It's pretty cold in here.
That's why you wear sweaters.
It's going to be pretty cold.
Are your nipples hot?
I'll try to make it snow in
all
here.
All day hot, Steven.
All day. So you guys, we got what? A week until Star Wars comes out.
when this comes out, it will be out already.
2 days. It already be out.
Are you guys ready?
How do you guys feel about watching Star Wars, guys?
Oh, man, it was great.
That one scene.
Remember that one part where you found out that Anakin wasn't Kylo Ren?
No.
And then everybody in the audience was like, what the fuck?
The part they found out that they didn't even cast Mark Hamill and that they lied?
Yeah.
Dude, that shit was crazy.
The CG recreated him down to his dick.
Oh, my God.
Down to his dick. You never saw it because they wore clothes. Because it was like
episode 6 when you see the Force version of Anakin, and then he looks a lot like the guy from 30 years from there when he's going to, you know.
And a dick, too.
And a dick. He had a fat one, though.
But yeah. Jesus Christ. It looks smooth.
And look, you can easily tell my girlfriend's in the room because she already left the bobby pin on the table. It's just.
God damn it.
Women, she do everything here. But no, for sure, I'm ready to see this movie. I
want to freaking watch it.
Those 2 years since they announced like the movie went by quick, right?
Yeah,
it was insane.
I think this whole year in general was just like, damn.
Well, see, last year we had a lot of Marvel movies, and then this year we had another batch of Marvel movies to kind of just keep
holding it down.
Because they're freaking milking it. They're milking all that stuff so they can get stuff.
Yeah.
When you pay billions of dollars for a fucking franchise, you better get your fucking money. Yeah.
Considering, let's say they paid $1 billion for the franchise and made that back in 2 movies.
Yeah.
Like, they are smart.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then they're still going to get more.
Oh, yeah. Way more.
That's why they're like Boba Fett spinoff.
They got Rogue One coming out next year.
Yep.
Or Rogue Squadron or Rogue One?
Rogue Squadron.
No, it's Rogue One. Because Rogue Squadron's a game.
Oh, that's true.
So they have that coming out next year. Then they have the next Star Wars Episode 8 coming out. You know,
like two years.
No, 2 years. Yeah, it's going to be every other year is going to be one of the numbers, and then the fillers are going to be, you know, the other one.
Yeah, freaking Mandalorian like backstory.
Did you hear what Rogue One is going to be about?
I didn't read up on it.
It was basically about that squad, Rogue One.
Yeah,
Hashtag Squad,
which was from the actual game.
Yeah. Well, they're trying to get the plans from the Death Star. So it's basically like, you know, it's like watching Halo Reach.
Well,
you know what's gonna happen.
I forgot the name of that one character from. I think it was Jedi Billy Academy. Mays. He was actually a bounty hunter, and he found it was a Jedi, and he was essentially the one that gave the plans to Princess Leia and 4. But that's not gonna be canon though.
Nothing's canon anymore.
Not Boba Fett. Is that what you're trying to say?
It's not Boba Fett.
I know.
Even Kano's on canon.
I forgot his name though.
Is
it the guy from Star Wars Rebels? Is that what you're talking about?
I believe so.
Kanan or Kanan?
Yes, he's the one.
Oh, really? So that's what I've been watching.
He's the one who gave. He was the one who originally gave the plans of the Death Star to Princess Leia, and that's why that's how she got a hold of that.
I'm not even kidding. You're blowing my mind right now because I watched fucking Star Wars Rebels, and it was pretty fucking fun. I just didn't know who
I was just watching this.
Who was who?
Yeah,
I was just
watching.
Do you guys think that the Solo kids are gonna come out?
They have to.
No hobo.
They have to.
No hobo.
I don't know, man.
Are you saying that you're gonna be like train hobos?
No. Well, from like the kind of character that Han Solo was, it just sort of makes sense. Like, yeah, he probably got a couple of kids here and there.
More than likely. Yeah, because I mean, obviously, this is just like comics and stuff, but like they have like 2 kids,
it's
and one of them becomes.
But that's it's not.
Yeah,
canon.
I know, because it's not canon. That's the only thing. That's the only thing I hate is the fact that
it's not.
No,
it's
not.
It literally was taken out the
game. Yeah, I know. It's just
they could have written it in.
No, what I'm saying is, but you never know.
If they're gonna put him in. Okay,
yeah.
Maybe he's Kylo Ren.
Well, in the actual comic books and the books, one of them was a Sith Lord. A Sith Lord, but it's not canon.
Was it Luke's kid or was it Han Solo's kid?
Because Luke never had children. Because if he fell in love, he becomes a Sith Lord.
Fell in love, became Sith Lord. It's crazy.
He was also gay.
Luke's guy. Well, he also liked incest.
Oh my God.
That's why he's making out with his sister the first movie.
But they didn't know. They didn't know until like
still wrong.
Never
Chris. Went back to it. Still wrong.
Christian goes to was it the family reunions and tries to find the hottest girl there? Like,
oh my god,
I didn't know.
I remember. I don't think I ever told the story, and I don't think I ever told you actually. But one time we were hanging out with this one girl. We all know her, friend of ours.
Yeah.
And I remember her telling me that I guess she went somewhere. I haven't seen her in years. I guess she told me that she went to like. She went with her family somewhere. She met a guy at this like party they went to. And then she was like, yeah, I was making out. And it was only till after we made out that someone told us we were cousins. Well, and my joke to her was always, well, that's why you don't make out with strangers at a family reunion.
And that's why she's.
Did you not realize I'm like my parents are taking me to this party? It has to be a family fucking party.
Yeah, near no.
Well, it could have been a family fucking party, but she's just well, getting there.
She was trying to make it to a family fucking party.
Well, no, he
she's
was
the only one down.
I don't know how to like feel about that. It's just like weird because
you feel
kind of. My nips are kind of standing up right now. But like, yeah, I don't get that. Like, how do you not fucking question things? Like, if I were to go to like a family party and then I just see something that like I don't know, I'm like. I'm going to assume it's family. I'm not fucking with it. That's why.
You don't want to roll the You're dice,
like,
man.
You walk into exactly. a room like, there's a potential for incest here.
Which one is my cousin's girlfriend?
That's where you do the one move where you stick your arm out, close your eyes, and spin around, and just hope you land on the person that isn't family.
And it's a 5-year-old. Like, fuck.
But it's not my cousin.
That got dark quick.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
Palette club.
Back to Star Wars.
I know, right? Do you think they're gonna do the Darth Maul being cut in half and being half cyborg thing?
It can't be.
They can.
Don't ever say can't.
I believe that's still part of canon, though.
Is it?
Yeah, I think the Clone Wars series is still part of canon.
Yeah, bitch.
Well, I know that,
but those are the Clone
just because
Wars.
It's not canon doesn't mean they can't draw from it. That's
no, that's true. But that would be 40 years? So.
Yeah.
No, but like, and here's the thing that
he would age too.
Wait, hold up.
He was still age.
Yeah, here's the thing that I've talked about like,
okay, Christian, the waist Yoda was machine. Like, what, 900 years old for like?
Yeah, but his race actually lives to be that
much. That's
how long
Darth
Maul, the Maul's race.
It's fucking fiction, bro. Like,
yeah, I know, right?
The Jedi's are so much Jedi's.
Christian's
so
throwing shit with their mind. It's like, the fuck?
Either way, one thing I've always talked about, like, Star Wars wise.
He fucked Lindsay Lohan, like, for real.
Is his real name Machete?
Oh, Jesus Christ. No, but either way, one thing I've always talked about, like, Star Wars and the fact that, like, all that stuff isn't canon anymore, I like that it's all of a sudden a brand new universe, and there's, like, we're going to take it in a complete direction, because it's all of a sudden it's really new again.
It's fresh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And for someone that wants to get back into it, or that wants to
get into it.
It's gonna just think of that. We're gonna have a new wave of Star Wars fans. It's gonna be like
Aww. More
than likely bigger than fucking Twilight.
I'm but
Twilight was pretty big, but
they're gonna
hate all the other.
Where's
Jar?
By the way, Christian, if I couldn't find, we did a Secret Santa thing with our friends yesterday. If I couldn't find something and it was out of the price range, I was gonna jokingly get you. The full Twilight series on Blu-ray.
God, if you it's got me that, I would have smashed it in front of everyone.
Well, Landry was like, well, if he doesn't like it, his girlfriend will.
No, don't
break it. Christian would have destroyed it in front of you. He would have looked like such a fucking piece of shit.
No, I would have been okay with it.
I thought you would have liked it because you're half wolf.
It's not my money. It's not my money. I don't care. It's
like, bitch, smash. That's why. No.
But I got him a boot instead.
Yeah.
Which, in all honesty, it's a way better gift.
Oh, hell yeah. It doesn't fit in my cabinet, but it's great.
It's a centerpiece now. It's going to be like on your table. Just put there, and they're like, why would you put flowers in it?
You know what's funny, though? And speaking of Twilight, I remember going to Comic-Con one year, and I remember seeing all these signs of like, Twilight ruined Comic-Con.
It was true.
It didn't really bug me, though.
No.
And that's the thing I've realized recently is that someone else's enjoyment of something doesn't really affect me too much.
The enjoyment doesn't affect me, but the popularity does. Because it makes you realize that, I mean, no offense to Twilight people, but you're idiots.
No,
but think about this. Twilight coming into Comic-Con actually helped out as well because a bunch of fans just started
I take the Christian approach,
It sold out. That's essentially what you want.
But it also took
the
tickets away from the people that wanted to go for it outside of Twilight.
Exactly,
and that's a double-edged sword, though. Yeah. Like you get a lot newer fans, and you you give people the opportunity to be introduced to newer things and cool things. So they went for Twilight, but then they see like something else they like. Then they see all the Doctor Who outfits and they're like, what the fuck is that? Let's go check that out.
I don't think Twilight necessarily ruined it. I think it was just all these things that are coming into Comic-Con, like the different kinds of movies aren't even like based on comics and stuff.
Yeah,
like,
that
they'll put in like shows and everything.
Well,
and
just, like, the comic section in Comic-Con was like a corner. And then everything else is like big corporations and shit.
Yeah, exactly. That's the thing that.
Was that in
the
corner as much as like you see a booth here, and then it's like Hasbro and all this other shit that doesn't let traffic get into that booth because of their lines are so big.
Yeah.
And then like it's still sprinkled.
Because I still remember going into like Comic Con like 2005 or something. It was probably like my first time, and I was able to go in with $5. I was able to buy a pass.
$15 kids pass.
Five fucking dollars.
10 years ago.
After four or three, I think, and now I can't even. Be around the fucking area.
Right? It's like, okay, Comic-Con's gonna sell tickets at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
They're like, all right, it'll won. Sold out. Like, goddamn.
Yeah, like, literally. Well, I would go right after fucking school, and I'd take the fucking trolley up there. I'd walk there. Hey, guys, how can I help you? I want to go into Comic-Con. $5, please. There you go. Here's your fucking bag.
I don't know why I went to Mario.
It was just shit like that, and obviously like a lot of the movies weren't really being advertised unless they were like kind of like big animated movies or like something that had like I wouldn't say like a nerd following, but you know,
yeah,
I know what you mean.
Like that's pretty much what it had, and now it's more like you guys want to go to Comic-Con? I heard Brad Pitt's gonna be there. Like, you know, it's just like there's just a lot of stuff that's going on where it's not really so much of like a comic convention anymore.
It's not, but the name stuck. It's a namesake. And if they were to change the name, I think people are going to be mad.
It's a meet and greet.
I'm in with Christian right here. Yeah. Like, you got to take the good with the bad, man.
Well, yeah, I think it's cool that it's there. I mean, since we live in the area and everyone knows Comic-Con week is coming up, don't drive downtown or through downtown or around downtown because you're not going to make it through. I mean, shit, some guy got mad and ran over how many of those zombies during the zombie walk? I think that guy just got convicted too.
No, he wasn't mad. He was confused
because he thought the zombie apocalypse was happening.
Is it happening? But it's like we know that you don't necessarily have to pay to get into Comic-Con to have fun at Comic-Con, like Comic-Con weekend.
No, you don't.
Because they do so much free shit now. But now it's like it used to be so much free shit. Now it's like you can get in if you have a badge at Comic-Con. Like, we have this event, but you have to have a badge.
That's the other thing about it. It's like I tell everyone, you need 2 days to really enjoy Comic-Con. You don't need all fucking 4 days. You need 2 days. One day to go inside, just kind of browse around like, oh, this is fucking awesome. Yeah, you just go into the exhibit hall. Second day, if you want to buy anything, that's about it. And whatever.
It's like buying like a season pass to like to SeaWorld, which like I said, we live in San Diego, so we can do
this. This makes a lot more sense to us.
Yeah. If you buy a season pass to SeaWorld, I was actually talking to a coworker of mine about this yesterday. She bought one for her and a friend bought one, and they went three times within last week.
Damn.
It was like one day they went to go see the like all the shows and stuff. The next day they went for the rides, and then the day after that they just went for one thing. I forget what it was. I think they went to go eat.
That's still pretty smart.
And then I left because we can do that.
Yeah.
But like you get your money's worth. It was actually a BOGO thing. It was like buy one season pass, get another season pass free.
Jesus.
So it was like worth the money, and she already made that money or already got that money's worth. So
Well, it makes you think though, like, would you have spent so much money otherwise? It's like, okay, I bought the season pass for SeaWorld. I'm more inclined to go and spend money. Had I not bought the season pass, probably just would have gone one day and saved
That's exactly what their goal is. They know that a lot of people have been leaving since Blackfish, but even before that, their sales were dropping. So they would buy a regular pass, get a free upgrade to a season pass, like a platinum pass.
Get a slice of fish just here.
That's essentially what now is becoming the norm. You buy the season pass and you just go there as many times as you want.
Yeah, you just go there and hang out.
That's why everyone got like the Disneyland. Disneyland.
I'm not joking. Yeah. Her and her friends go to Disneyland like every weekend.
Yep, they do.
Because
they want to hang out next week.
And they just go and chill. They go there, drink, and hang out, and then come back.
And honestly, the passes was only like $200-something, but now it's
like $1,000, right? Pass that sells
it's blackout. $1,000 VIP. You can get that one, or you can get like the $800 one, which is they sell at blackout days.
And that's for one person,
but it's still 318 days. It's ridiculous.
See, one person.
That's the thing. That was I'm a basic bitch.
So, like, it's because they notice how popular it's been getting.
I settle with anything. Like, and you know, I can go out of all 365 days. I cannot go to these many. Yeah, fuck it. I'm not paying like $90 to keep going back there.
But
like,
you also know why they're doing that too, because like the Star Wars land is also going to be opening up this year or next year.
I want to see the Star Wars land, but I mean, I'm a Harry Potter fan. I want to go to Universal to see that fucking Hogsmeade
or the possibly named and Nintendo freaking land at Universal Studios. Oh my
god! And also the Simpsons freaking town.
Well, I think they expanded, right?
Yeah, they did.
But it's bigger in Orlando, I believe.
Yeah, it is.
But
penis.
Even then, I don't like crowds, so I don't try to avoid those things.
It's an experience, Steven.
Yeah,
it's
like, you have to go for the experience.
I always fucking hate a crowd, dude. I've always hated crowds.
No, I don't like busy areas, but like if there's an experience in which I can be a part of or feel like I'm a part of, then yeah, I want to do it. Like I want to go and get my fucking wand and shit and be like stand there and wave this shit and it picks you and you fucking. I want to do all that shit. Sounds nerdy.
You know, if you don't take someone that's either female or younger than you, people are gonna think you're a child molester.
No,
it's gonna be all adults, Steven. All.
Yeah, well, I'm going to think you're troublesome.
Yeah, think about it this way, Steven. When the books came out, we were still kids.
I know,
but
right?
Then once the movies came out, we were already full-blown adults. No,
when the books finished, we graduated high school.
Yeah.
Like,
and when the movies came
I was in elementary school when it started.
We're full-blown adults and all the movies started. Came out.
Come on. No, you don't, Steven. You never have good
you
stories.
You have no say in this.
Never, Steven.
I got a good Harry Potter story.
Oh, God.
So I was talking to this girl, right? And she told me that her sister was really into Harry Potter. Uh-huh. And her older sister had grown up with the books. She's the same age as we are.
Uh-huh.
So she, as the books came out, she was getting older and getting older. So when the last movie came out, she went to the movie theater and they were all excited and shit like that. She says that people were so excited in the movie theater, you couldn't hear any of the dialogue because people kept fucking yelling and screaming and shit like that. That's how big it was.
Yeah.
So they go to the movie theaters. They watch this whole movie. They're like, oh my God, this was amazing. This is the end of a chapter. It's the end of like something that I started when I was a child. And then she's like, so we got back home. And then my sister was all excited and emotional. And then she puked.
Wow.
But see, when she told me the story, I thought she puked in the movie theater. So in my mind, she was like, oh my God, Harry Potter.
I don't think I've ever been that excited where I just vomited. Like, honestly.
No, I've never been so excited I puked. I've barely been so drunk I puked. Let's put it that way.
I'm sorry, man.
Oh, my God. I remember told that puke. Well, I've told you guys the puking story about the girl on the ride. This is why I don't like going on a lot of those spinning rides that kind of suck you into the wall at amusement parks. Because when I was in elementary school, there was this one girl who she wasn't in my class, actually. She
I
was
can't
there.
Talk about this without laughing. Just kidding.
It was like me and a buddy went in there. We got into the little ride. It's like a little spaceship, and it spins
calm
around.
Calm down,
and
Janice.
You get stuck on the wall from G-Force. Mm-hmm. Well, there's a girl, when it started going, who ended up puking. So that shit rode up her face while she was on it. And then when it slowed down, it finally fell down. So she got like puked on like three times, basically.
She got thorough puke wash. Just fucking.
And it was her own.
Jesus Christ. People have sensitive stomachs sometimes, man.
Yeah, dude. Harry Potter, bro.
Was it with you that I went on it with last year? Where we went to Del Mar?
I think so. I don't remember.
Where it like pulled you up.
Yeah.
She was cool. It was like, all right, cool. But. I love those rides.
I think someone still vomited in that ride, too.
Carlos. That's the same girl that told me about like. So a buddy of ours, he went to stay with them, right? And in the country they're from, they don't have cereal. And like in America, morning cereal is like it's a very common thing. So when he goes over there, he's like, oh, do you guys have any cereal? So the family was like, well, we can get cereal. So they go out and they get cereal. And then he's like, well, do you have milk? Well, the way that it works in that country is like they bring the milk daily. So it's that daily supply of milk. And obviously it's not refrigerated. Like refrigerators are not really... The milk is not really a thing. Oh, so they give him the milk and he pours it in the cereal and he's like, well, this is room temperature.
They're fucking up.
Sure. I'll eat it. And then they're like, do you guys like have any ice maybe? So I guess what they had, instead of having little ice cube trays, they had just like a tub, like a little tray that they put in there with just water. So it was a nice solid block of ice. So what the mom did, she grabbed it and she picked at it and she threw chunks and threw it in the cereal and he was like, is that good?
Jesus Christ. Okay.
Steven, have you ever heard of an ice box?
Not ice box. There.
Apparently they hadn't.
No, I'm saying, like, have you heard of an ice box?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what an ice box is.
Yeah.
We just grew out of that.
Well, in that country, they didn't.
Yeah. It's like, use your ice pick in the ice box. You did it right.
Jesus.
Yeah, well, and then the whole time he was telling me this, I just couldn't get the thought of, like, hot cereal out of my head, where it's like, because hot cereal is a thing, but not in, like, hot freaking frosted flakes. So we kept making the joke of caldo de sucaritas, which is basically frosted flake stew. And they were like, ooh, nice big pot of frosted flake stew. Would you like some?
As a man who doesn't like stews or soups.
Oh my god.
Well, Frosted Flakes stew.
I would hate that. But like, I know me and my girlfriend.
Would be down.
Dad,
no.
Wait, when were we supposed to?
No.
We're supposed to do something.
No.
Nope. Gummy worm challenge.
Maybe.
Okay.
Oh god. Don't fucking do it.
We just ate.
Who would?
I know. That's the reason why too. To
really hot cereals.
No, the milk. Having hot milk probably give you the hot shits, and I'm not down for that.
You and me? We got this, Josh.
All right, we're gonna video this and make sure you guys all heard they're gonna eat hot. They're gonna have what is it?
Cereal and I'm not talking stew. About. I'm not talking about Frosted Flakes. I'm talking about we mix a bunch of cereals and we put hot milk.
Wait a minute.
Oh, now you're gonna back out?
No, hot milk isn't.
Are
that
we gonna
bad,
be wearing
actually.
Christmas sweaters?
Well, yeah, that's true.
Hot milk isn't that bad because you make hot chocolate, and guess what that is? It's hot milk.
I use powder and water.
Have you ever mixed a bunch of cereals
no,
regularly?
That's how I make it.
What's mixing a bunch of cereals regularly tastes like shit.
It's great. No. Oh, what? What the hell do you
mix? A bunch of different cereals
what
together?
Do you mix?
Yes, dude. Okay. All right. Okay, all right. We're about to break this motherfucker down here.
This guy does not know how to mix the cereals.
Honey Bunches of Oats and Honey Nut Cheerios. Honey Bunches of Oats and Honey Nut Cheerios.
Honey Bunches of Oats and Honey Nut Cheerios.
Cocoa Puffs.
I got another one for you. I got another one for you. We take Honey Nut Cheerios. No. Honey Nut Cheerios, which is great. And you take Golden Grahams, homie. Ooh. I'm mixing
cocoa.
Cereals, Steven, but it doesn't sound disgusting.
Cocoa.
I'm thinking Kix.
Why are you mixing?
Honey Nut Cheerios and Wheaties.
You don't mix Wheaties with Kix, man.
Wheaties is the grossest thing of that.
No, Wheaties is actually pretty good.
Yeah, Wheaties is pretty good.
Brand cereal is fucking nasty.
I always complain about raisins.
Okay, hold on. Let's put it this way. To me, it's like eating really something that's really, really wet but still dry.
I'm going to give you another one. I'm going to give you another one, Steve. Chex Corn, which are delicious, by the way,
What's
by themselves.
Name?
Take Chex Corn and you put freaking Honey Nut Cheerios, man. That's just delicious.
Oh, what was your name again? Or how about I just get a... I don't know. A canister of raisins and some bran flakes thrown together.
Raisin brands.
No.
Oh.
Shit.
I hate $1 million raisin idea. Bread.
I hate raisins.
That's why I like Wheaties, because Wheaties is like raisin bran without the fucking raisins.
No, I hate Wheaties.
It's not like the Wheaties, like the bran flakes are really thick.
I was the motherfucker that only had Fruit Loops, Fruit Pebbles.
Do you guys add sugar to your Rice Krispies?
No.
No.
Nah, it's overkill.
I have to. It's just.
Yeah, I don't.
Really?
I don't either.
Oh, see, well, for context, I also eat like just like plain shit. Like I'll just eat Rice Krispies. I'll eat regular Cheerios.
Well, no,
I'll eat regular Corn Flakes. Well, I'll eat Kix.
Rice Krispies
and Wheaties. Fucking love Wheaties.
Sweetness to it, right?
No.
What Kix? Kix has a.
That's why you don't make a Rice Krispies treat.
Rice Krispies.
Would just fucking.
You can just eat it normally. I don't know why people have to add sugar to it.
Because it tastes great that way.
So.
I don't eat sugar.
Okay, let's put it this way.
Do you?
It's like eating Corn Flakes or Frosted Flakes.
Do you?
I prefer Frosted Flakes. This is one of the few ones where I do prefer Frosted Flakes.
Okay.
But I eat Corn Flakes regularly. I grew up only eating Corn Flakes.
They're more than good.
They're great.
Great.
They're great. God,
I don't have any more TV time.
See, I always saw this with a couple of buddies. We talked about would you rather have Tang or Sunny D, and a lot of
I'd rather have Sunny D because
surprisingly
you can't fuck up a mixture for Sunny D because it's already made.
Exactly.
Well, yeah,
but there are some people that actually do and still enjoy Tang.
What if you want an extra Tang in your Tang?
But I fucking hate Sunny D. Well, it tastes like ass and medicine.
Well, Sunny D is gross.
Yeah.
Sunny D is the only juice that like after you're done drinking you're like, can I have some water? I'm thirsty.
Yeah. It's so salty.
Yeah, if you gave
me
the choice of Sunny D and Tang, I would probably shoot myself in the head.
Josh, what are you doing? I'm not taking any of these.
Like, if
how dare you?
Like, if they gave me Sunny D, Tang, and a pistol, like, you have to pick one of these.
What kind of third world country are we living in that I have to drink Tang or Sunny D?
God bless America.
We have choices, and Josh likes neither.
I think it's... Turkey?
What the?
I heard the Fugees are performing over there.
Okay. Well, anyways.
Maybe. I don't know.
You have a weird way of mixing your cereal, man.
He doesn't. That's the issue.
I know.
I didn't think about it when I was a kid. I just had cereal and I was like.
When you get Honey Bunches of Oats, do you get Honey Bunches of Oats with almonds and the oats, or do you just get the Honey Bunches?
Packaged peanuts.
I fucking don't. I get cocoa.
Anything else?
I don't eat sugar cereal anymore.
I don't get the regular one. I get anything that has the add-ons.
I fucking love them.
Yeah. Honey Bunches of Oats with almonds was great.
No, no.
Yeah, it is pretty good.
I know. That's why you get the ones. That's why you don't get the plain one. You get the add-on ones because they're better. They taste way better.
The fucking the one that's yellow, that's the one you don't get. You get the blue one.
Well,
that's the
I blue, always the get one, that one.
Yeah,
the blue one's the best
that's one. The plain one. Look, man. It's just I eat plain shit.
Steven has no flavor.
And I thought I was a basic bitch.
That's why he's salt. That's why he's salty as fuck.
Oh.
Damn. I broke it.
Damn. No sweets.
Do you guys remember the name of the giraffe from Toys R Us?
Jeffrey.
All right, cool.
Dahmer.
All right, Jeffrey Dahmer, right, question, the guys. Giraffe.
Next question.
It was like, the next question.
No, that was literally all I wanted to ask.
Really? You didn't know that?
No, I knew it.
Oh, you know? Okay. Oh, you want to see if we still remember it?
I wonder if they knew it. Comment below.
Comment down below if you remember the giraffe's name that
like
we just said.
Like and subscribe.
And we're done.
And if you remember, and if you remember the slogan,
hashtag shave
what
out.
What is the slogan?
He had a
hashtag
slogan.
Hashtag Christmas arm swear.
I'm not gonna tell you because they're gonna find out later.
Hashtag
this is more than good. It's great.
It's all right.
Oh my god.
I don't put a smile on. Put a smile on. That's McDonald's.
No, yeah.
We hey, Tony.
If you notice that a lot of
if I could, I would be you.
Honestly,
you're
the 90s.
And only
oh, actually, no.
With the one and only taste, you know how to make breakfast tasty. Frosted Flakes are more than good. Shave Christian.
Hashtag Shave Christian.
If you know, that's actually how they get people to buy shit. Just the way their slogans.
Jingle.
Yeah,
that's,
slogans
that's
are
exactly
great.
Why jingle companies exist.
That's why I like the Matchbox ones because that dude just talked really, really fast. Like, dude,
no, that's our
spoken. We need to get
some. Just Matchbox 20. It's just Rob Thomas singing. It's just like the ocean. Buy our album, please. It's not even our song.
Oh god, it's working great though.
Best song we ever made. It wasn't even ours.
It wasn't even his. Right?
Nope.
It wasn't even them. It was just me.
Slogans and jingles, honestly, they hook you in to get shit.
Not really.
That's why you still sing Hotline Bling?
Yeah, but I'd never.
But I didn't buy Hotline Bling.
Yeah, I didn't buy it.
Like, you didn't buy it on
iTunes? I go to the local pawn shop and request some Hotline Bling.
I lied. I pirated it, but I didn't buy it.
Yeah, I just got one of the YouTube rippers.
I can't really do that with cereal, okay? Like, makes no sense.
Bullshit, you could buy like almost bootleg cereal at the
fucking
store.
Tell
it's
me
like what? The big ass bag of crap.
Well, yeah, but that's still you're still buying it.
No. You got to get the quicker brand. The quicker brand is the same shit, just in a big ass bag, and you don't have to worry about a box.
No
you
boxes,
stick it into
man.
Like something else, and
you know why it's
later.
Expensive? Because it's in a box, fool.
Yeah, it's in bags.
Bags.
They cut costs.
How much that box is? It's like
I'm
an extra 15 cents, homie.
I say backs.
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 Extra 15 cents.
Honey, want to lick my backs?
My backs or my box?
My backs.
My backs. Hashtag
I remember
Shane
this
Christian.
One dude who was dating this chick that we knew. He was from Chicago.
Chicago, I remember.
Chicago.
I remember he was listening to Waka Flocka. God. And he was like, hey, man, this guy here, he's from my hometown. And he just really wanted to make it known that he's from his hometown. But the whole time I'm like, no, he's not from Atlanta, dude. What you talking about?
Southern rapper, man. Like, well, he's got that accent.
I know, this guy right here, he's from my hometown.
He probably saw him.
Yeah, man, from my hometown. Yeah, like you know the guy personally.
You know, I think I met
the
guy once,
him,
and I don't remember him
that
well.
If you're watching this.
You're a tool.
You're a tool. And I stole your knives.
Did you?
Yeah, I was really drunk and mischievous with Kiki one night. Oh, yeah, then you guys came from Viejas that one night. That was the same night.
You stole his knives?
Yeah, I had two knives and I was going around and having knives.
I don't remember that at all.
I came with Kiki and I was drinking at one way.
You see, we always have some weird things that we do. We go to people's parties and steal shit or
no,
shit.
We don't.
Yeah, you do. Steal fuck, you broke a shelf,
okay, look.
That's not stealing.
No.
You broke something.
Christian put this in a terrible way.
Something
if you ever had a party and we were at your house and shit went missing, it probably wasn't us.
Bullshit.
Christian's just making it seem like we go around and steal people's TVs and shit.
No, we don't steal TVs. It's like something minor, like something small.
Like your remote batteries.
Like that. It's usually something small, but there's a tendency of shit being broken, but it's never our fault.
No, shit got broken because like sometimes people are just drunk. And
they're just stupid.
Not like
but we've done some dumb things, but that's not that dumb.
Let me clarify how I broke the shelf. So when I was stone cold sober, I walked into the bathroom and the fucking bathroom was really small. So you would hit it regularly. Mm. And it's because the people that lived there were also considerably shorter.
Short people.
So it probably wasn't really an issue.
Not midgets. They're short.
They were just shorter. So I hit it with my shoulder whenever I walked in.
Yeah.
Well, when I was drunk,
everybody
obviously
hit
I couldn't
it.
Fucking like maneuver.
Everybody hit it though.
I hit the shelf, and I hit it too hard. But I remember leaving the shelf on like on the sink, and then I took a piss and I left. And later on, she came back out and she was like, "So someone broke a shelf." And I remember sitting right there in front of my friend, and I'm just like, "Oh, that is fucked up. Who would break that shelf? Who would do such a thing?" And then I remember leaning over and being like,
it was me.
It's funny, that same night we took a shit ton of beers too.
Okay, that night I accidentally stole a bottle of liquor. Okay,
you stole a bottle of liquor. I had a bag of like 12 beers and we took it to my car.
And y'all ditched me for that party because I was at work. So I was not involved in this fucking delinquency.
You guys want to see
it? No, but you guys we've still taken some things, but not like very valuable things. It's usually either alcohol or like something small breaks.
You guys want to find out if I won?
What'd you get, Josh?
What'd you win?
No, let's find out.
He's going to show everybody, but he's not going to tell us.
It's going to be all blurry. So you're going to peel it, and what did you get?
Oh,
you know the prize is on the thing.
Holy shit, free small drink.
Oh, sweet.
Shit.
No, oh, I got that today, but I accidentally threw it away.
So did I. So we can all get small drinks together, I guess.
Well, no, he had small fries, and he freaking threw it away.
Small fries and drink.
Yep.
No purchase necessary.
God damn.
Subject to verification, redeem at participating colleges.
We've got to verify that this year.
Also, no. I always think that's great when...
Shut the
fuck up. Hey, fuck you, right? You know
what, this is Josh's moment.
You don't have to read the terms of agreement for? Yes. Are you going to sign it with your blood?
Yes.
Oh, sweet.
Your mama's blood.
Oh!
Hip hop horn.
No, I was gonna say that every company always does something like that where they throw out like an advertisement saying, "Oh, you may win something like that." Everyone always buys the stuff for it.
Not really. I never go to college.
What?
Okay.
You went. Honestly, look at that. You bought that large cup.
You know what? You know what that always reminds me of, though. Did you guys ever play the fucking McDonald's
Monopoly? Thing? Yes, we did.
And the fucking people that won for the last few years were the guys that made the pieces for it.
Really? Essentially, yeah.
They actually got caught up in it and they got a lot of trouble for that.
Wait, so this.
I won a lot of free meals. I won a lot of free meals. I thought about that.
It's fucking false.
A lot of free meals.
Yeah, exactly.
Wait. Do they still do it?
Once in a while it comes around.
They do. They do once in a while.
It's in October. All the time, but I know they changed it before.
Well, see, here's the thing that I'm wondering is like, in the age of the internet, how the fuck do you not just go on? How is there not like a subreddit where you go on and you're like, these are the pieces I have. What do you have? Let's get together and share.
Because the pieces weren't made and the people that won the pieces were working
now
for the company.
There's a reason why they make so many duplicates of one so you don't technically win. It's impossible to win it because when the people
it's not impossible because that's against the law.
That's true.
That's false advertisement and fraud, bitch. Mm-hmm.
Either way, no, but I'm saying, like, in the age of the internet, how, well, now that there is a possibility of winning, how do you not just go on a subreddit and be like, hey, look, this is what I got, this is what you got, let's get together one way or another?
Because I'm selfish.
Yeah.
Who you want to win with.
And on top of that, you don't necessarily
win. And also, it depends on the prizes.
You win a chance to win that prize. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like, the $1 million thing, I think it was, like, if you actually get all three pieces or whatever.
That's only two.
It's like you out of 50 people.
It was Boardwalk and freaking Parkway.
Well, yeah, that's what it's like. You out of like fucking like 100 people could win.
Reminds me, we need to play Monopoly again one day.
But, plot twist. McDonald's.
That's when I played. So. We played with Brad, and then he all butt hurt.
Yeah, but we ain't playing with him, though.
Monopoly never ruined my friendships.
It didn't ruin my friendship. I was never really friends.
It just causes a scene.
No.
Gigantic.
Especially when you're eating donuts.
But it did affect my relationship with my dog.
Did he eat your
pizza? Oh, look at me. I'm Josh. My dog's dead.
No,
he's fine. He's just an asshole.
I know, yeah.
Your dog's the shit.
Your dog's cool, though. I love your dog.
My dog's pretty cool, too. Homie, what?
Nah, my dog's a piece of shit. Right. I know he is.
He likes to feel.
He's getting really fucking big now, so it's just like.
Well, it's a big dog.
Anytime.
So he's becoming a bigger piece of shit.
He's going to knock over a lot of
what
shit.
What you want at that button?
If he hasn't already, I'm probably going to get home today. I'm going to fucking find all the things that he knocked over, chewed on. Because you'd be like, I don't even give a fuck anymore. I'm just going to go to sleep.
Like, I'm kind of in this dilemma whether or not I should sell my Xbox One.
What?
Whether or not I should sell my Xbox One. But I got to play Halo.
Jesus. You did that with your Wii, too.
I sold the Wii U, but I played the game I wanted to play for it.
And I did
it for
the
3DS.
You sold it because you couldn't get the game.
No. I wanted Smash Bros., but the game that I bought with it is the one I beat. I completed Mario 100%.
That's true, yeah.
All right, we helped whatever.
Do it. I'm also down to do like some sort of speed run for Mario 64 because I can pass it pretty quickly.
No, I want to do it for Mario 3.
100%.
If anybody out there is selling a regular-ass Nintendo or a Super Nintendo with Super Mario All-Stars and a controller, hit me up. Put the email down at the bottom and then hit me up. I'm going to buy that shit.
I wouldn't mind speed running some games. Some games I speed run before.
If you're watching it on the YouTube app, you got to press the little arrow button that's going to be
it's
right
like
down there.
It's not like Steven has a Wii U.
And then
no, we don't care.
You don't.
But
so
no,
so
I
we can get all of it from him.
No, I want the original.
And then you comment on the thing.
Yeah, but how will we, like, you know, film it?
Right, but Steven, do you have a controller outside of there? Oh, no, you have a Wiimote, right?
You're mine, bro. That's how far Nintendo is.
What?
Oh, your mind. I just think your mind. I'm like, I don't get what that means.
I love you too, man.
Just get the all you need is just a classic controller and you'll be fine. Yeah. That's all you really need.
Yeah, but 3. I mean, you still have to buy it, so.
The game costs probably like $10.
Okay, so when it comes to your old consoles, how long do you wait till you give them away, till you sell them or?
Never. Fucking never.
Really?
Never, yeah, never really sold my consoles.
I still have my N64, my GameCube, even though it doesn't fucking work. Still have a lot of the games for the N64. The Wii, I sold that one. It wasn't even worth it anymore.
Never sold my consoles because somebody stole them. No, because someone usually gives it away, and I don't want to say who, but I know that person knows who it is.
The one that wants to be on.
If the ones that are actually do watch it, they know who they are, because that person gave away our Sega with like 30 games that we had. Our freaking PS2 gave it away as well.
Good job.
And then, well, I saw my PS3. My brother sells his PS3. I have my PS4, and he has.
Look, Christian, it teaches you loss. You can either watch The Lion King, or you can have your console sold.
No, because honestly, there's some games I want to play on there. Like, I wouldn't mind speedrunning those games too. Yeah, and those games are really great games.
Well, they don't see in the hindsight. Like, I like to see.
They're valuable in the future.
Yeah. Look. Yeah, I still have my 64. I still have my Sega. I still have my PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2,
on the cartridge.
And my 360. My brother has his PS3. And they're just there.
Because
I'm never going to let them go.
But see, because there's just one game I do. I went to my speedrun.
I got the Legends.
And not only that, it's an obscure game.
But I Slayer at least in this day and age, there's such thing as backwards compatibility.
Yeah, but there's for certain games, though. Because there's a lot of games that they don't really have. That they don't really have.
Certain games?
Yes. Like for instance, Sega. Think about this. In Sega, I used to play the Beavis and Butthead game that was on there.
I
can speedrun that game.
Oh yeah, I watched them.
I can beat that game like that.
Fucking lie.
And it's a really difficult game. It's really difficult.
Yeah, dude. It was like when you guys were playing it. It was like you and Kiki, and I was like, "What the fuck? How do you guys even know this?"
I played the crap out of the game. Like, I wouldn't mind speedrunning that game because I've timed myself. Oh,
Revolution
the last
X.
Time. So can that we, takes forever though.
Yeah, that
so
does.
Can we do
it's
this?
A rail shooter.
We can.
Can this be like something?
But here's
else?
The thing. That game I can beat in probably like under 2 hours, maybe 2 hours.
Yeah, but it's.
It's a great game, though.
It was a pretty fun game.
It was a hard game. It was really hard.
Nah, you know what you should play? Talking about a hard game? That Simpsons game for the Sega, Bart's Nightmare.
That impossible-ass game?
Yeah.
I remember that game.
I've gotten 4 pages is the most I've ever gotten.
I think that's about as far as I ever got, too.
Yes, 4 pages.
And that was trying.
That
like,
was before your time. Sorry about that.
Oh, dude, that game was
hard. That game was difficult.
Fuck!
It's not your fault. It's my fault.
Well, like, basically, you had to collect these pages, right? Mm-hmm. But you were on the street.
Slenderman.
You were going sideways on the street, and things constantly try to hit you. So you had to run into the page, step on it, which would take you to 2 doors. You had to pick between one of them, and you had to beat the minigame at the end of that.
Yeah.
So every page was almost like fighting your own boss.
Press
it was
the clown.
Super fucking
so
difficult.
So was this a single-player game?
Or yes, it was. Yeah. It was single-player.
No, I was going to say it was a multiplayer game with minigames.
Did you guys play the Chippendales multiplayer game on...
For a second,
that was too racy.
Yeah,
never did.
You didn't play Chippin' Dale.
Oh yeah,
that's what I was gonna say.
Nope,
I
never did.
I also don't play Magic Mike. I just like,
like honestly, there is a bunch of games I wouldn't mind coming back to.
You've unlocked Chris Ford.
And a lot of old beat 'em ups from the Sega. I've destroyed by myself. Like Streets of Rage, I've destroyed that game by myself. And that game
is
hard.
The first one
is difficult.
Hard as shit when you get towards the end.
That one's hard. And also,
or wait,
Golden Axe.
Did you ever do
the
elevator glitch on the elevator one where they would get to the like. They'd come at you, and you could
throw
grab
them
and throw
them off. Yeah.
Yeah, that shit was like, all right, cool, whatever.
You beat the stage a lot faster than that way.
And then if you get to level 8, like all boss levels, it's all the bosses.
It's all bosses. It's
like,
difficult.
Did you guys ever 101% Donkey Kong 64?
I've never played Donkey Kong 64.
No, I never played Donkey Kong 64.
Never played Donkey Kong 64.
You had to buy the expansion pack for
it. Yeah, exactly.
Because
it's an add-on.
I borrowed it from a friend, and it didn't work. Same thing with the Zelda game.
And I have it.
Majora's
so
Mask.
Yeah, Majora's Mask.
101%. All you
try.
Get is like a secret ending where it's just like a blooper.
Donkey Kong flips you off and tells you to get a life. Fuck
okay.
You. Leave your house.
Okay.
Who are all the Kongs?
King, Donkey, and Genghis.
Like I know Dixie, Diddy, Donkey,
from Star Trek.
Was it
Kong,
Cranky,
Conful.
I know Jackass part of the joke.
No shit. But does anybody actually know all the Kongs?
I know most of them.
No. Dixie, Diddy, and Donkey and Cranky.
And Cranky, yeah, is the main one. But there was the one with the fucking sunglasses.
Cool Kong.
No.
Shao Kong.
Funky.
Funky Kong is his name?
Yeah, it was
that's weird. Funky.
Shao Kong.
Shao Kong.
Donkey King.
Tiny. Lanky.
Jesus Christ. There's a lot of Kongs.
Right. Well, yeah, those are all playable.
I love the Dinky.
There's a lot of Kongs.
I forget the name of the one that dies in one of the games, but she's like, what? This bitch.
They get gnarly.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do.
Like, brutally. Like,
they told her to choose in between
a poacher.
The gun and the other thing.
No, she got poached.
Oh, oh God, that sucks.
See, by Mario.
Is home.
It's a me, bitch.
Which reminds me, I also saw a trailer of Tarzan. I'm done. That's right. It.
Okay. I don't know why you
saw it. I didn't see it. I saw that existed. Bad. I saw a thumbnail.
I don't know. I don't care.
Neither do I. I never care about Tarzan. I didn't care about that level in Kingdom Hearts. Don't care about the fucking TV show they
hold
had.
Hold on. That level in Kingdom Hearts was pretty fucking
it was
cool.
Pretty hard.
Not Clayton. Not Clayton.
That's the only part you ever say by it. But I mean, the coolest part of it was actually like
the fight.
Lighting. But then it got annoying when you had to get somewhere and you had to fucking do it every time.
Yeah, every time.
Okay, yeah, that was kind of annoying.
But that boss fight was great.
Or trying to get fucking Mystery Goo. And you're like, oh, this is this spot or a Halloween town
yeah,
where they're going to pop up at.
Yeah, because you needed that this for the ultimate Halloween. Weapon, which is
and this
ridiculous.
Is how you know we're real fans, by the way.
Yeah,
this is how you
exactly.
know we're real fans.
And by the way, we are waiting for the third freaking game ready.
Third
Kingdom
Hearts.
Christ.
It might I'm come not. Out next year because the pre-orders are already out, if you didn't know that, Christian.
I'm what?
Not. You can already pre-order the game.
Oh, I'll be back, Christian. Guys. You fucked up.
I'll be back.
You're not a real fan.
One thing I was going to say, and going back to games we're like expecting, and because we're looking forward to playing the new Final Fantasy games.
No, we're not.
Okay, so Strife recently they showed the trailer to Final Fantasy VII. They showed like a fighting system that
yes.
was like,
it was
it's
weird.
Live action.
Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Yeah, yeah, Final Fantasy VII Remake. And it's like, it's live action, but it still has like the menus on the side, like what you can pick. Mm-hmm. So recently I was playing Parasite Eve again. I don't know if you remember this, but when the PlayStation first came out, the PlayStation.
Yeah.
There was a game called Parasite Eve by Squaresoft, which eventually became
Square Enix. Yeah.
And it was basically this
Parasite Eve, Jesus.
Yeah, yeah. It so like I remember you being like an opera house, and all of a sudden this like demonic looking creature, carnage looking thing comes out of nowhere and infects everyone.
Let me stop you there. Parasite Eve is actually one of those rare games that people actually pay $100 for.
43.
Really?
Yes, it's on the list of one of the rare one some rare games of PlayStation. Also, if you have the original one that's not the greatest hits one, it's actually a rare game.
I will keep that in mind because that is what I was playing.
Yes.
Also, if you have a copy of Conker's Bad Fur Day, it's worth a lot.
Yeah, Conker's Bad Fur Day.
Son of a bitch, still. I had one.
Aww,
you sure did, Steven. You sure did.
I do.
Well, I was playing Parasite Eve, and the fighting system was basically what reminded me of that.
Yeah.
Because you're moving around, you're fighting, but you're still moving around that fight area, and you're picking your attack. So you go into your menu, you pick, say you want to use haste or slow or any of that, or scan.
Diggity dope.
You pick it, check you implement it, and then it does it. And also when you want to shoot, like you pick your target and then you'll shoot.
Yeah.
You technically shoot at it.
No, so
I
remember.
Holy shit.
I've seen playthroughs of that.
That's
game.
Kind of what, whenever I hear anything about Final Fantasy and like, oh, the new system isn't that, I'm like, well, that's kind of what I think what it'll be like, which is, I guess, not as new as I figured.
I David, see it in two ways. I see it in two games.
The real question is,
King Damn.
Are you going to get Pokken Tournament for the Wii U?
Yes, like instantly.
Pokken, yeah.
Liar.
Yeah.
I said Pokken, motherfuckers.
Pokken.
I know. Okay.
You gonna get Pokken? You gonna get Pokken on your Wii?
I know, man. It's called Pokken Monsters.
He's from Japan.
Japan.
It comes. Japan. I believe it comes out in March of next year.
Yep.
You mean of next month.
If you do get it, I'm going to your house.
Yeah, in March
I'm
of next
not
month.
Leaving your house until that game has been beaten. I'm gonna go to your place. We're gonna play that game, and I'm gonna make sure that game's been beaten.
Yeah,
maybe three or four times.
I fucking want to play that game
and
so bad.
Like Chris is gonna be going over to you. I was like, dude, let's just fucking play.
And we need to find a way to stream that.
You can.
Yeah, I've done a couple already.
All right, sweet. We're doing that.
What are you guys doing? I want to do it.
Pokken.
Obviously, Kristen doesn't care about this podcast at all because he asked the most redundant questions.
He will fight you. Keep saying that.
He will wiener fight you, fool.
I will wiener fight you, and I will dock you.
Do you have a shield?
I don't need a shield. Full on to dock, man.
Yeah, my balls are my shield.
Oh,
see the way Christian does it is like it's like thumb war, but whoever's dickhead manages to encapsulate the other person's dickhead first. Like a Chinese, ooh, I won, bro.
it's like that anime. Was it, I think it was Parasite.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
It's actually,
is that something that happens?
Well, it's just a mutant that freaking just engulfs him.
Oh, okay.
That's essentially what I was seeing. I was like, oh cool. Well, now I'm part. Now you are me.
Now I am your penis.
Anime is actually not that bad.
I am one of you.
But anyways.
But my girlfriend is now melting into the floor.
You're getting really nerdy in this one. It's pretty great. I like it.
Wait, is she on LSD?
Yeah, I think
most
so.
Likely.
I'm under on LSD? Yeah. Yeah, she's on LSD, yes. Right.
Well, that happens.
If you take it two more times, you're legally retarded. I'm not kidding.
Yeah, I kind of figured it's
it is known.
Acid.
It is known.
And it burns your freaking... It is your burned your freaking brain.
She's not really on LSD.
It hurts your brand, fool. Just leave it alone, right? It hurts your brand.
My brand.
A raisin?
Brand.
But yeah, I'm really down to do Mario 64 100% speedrun.
Go for it, dog.
Boy.
We're doing a lot of live streams. I mean,
we have been.
Fucking run that shit through, dog.
I need to practice.
Dog.
You don't need to practice, but I thought you can do it right now.
Yeah, I can. Let's see. Let me bring up my N64 right now.
All
right. That's right there. Right there.
That is easy. Blowing it.
Well, I got this glitch in Super Mario 3 I want to show everybody, but like, you know, got to get a copy, see how I can capture it. So it's going to happen eventually.
Ooh. All right. Well, aside from video game talk, and this is the sexy stuff right here.
This is Halloween.
Ooh.
Everybody make a scene.
Who saw the X-Men Apocalypse trailer?
Not me.
That shit looks whack.
I'm not watching it.
I am not looking for it. X-Men has not always been hits, man. And this one looks like the one that's going
to
be
that. I'm going
to
say this.
It's the abusive boyfriend. You have to realize after certain
I made that
times.
Analogy last time with horror movies.
Yeah.
Cinematically.
They keep beating you. You just can't take
movies
it anymore.
Movies are
You know what it looks like?
First class
class is not bad.
It reminds me of the third Blade movie.
But, oh, don't say that,
but
dude.
But anytime they...
don't
anytime
say that.
They,
how dare you?
Well, everyone knows the anime... everyone knows the anime series is great.
Huh?
Everyone knows the anime series from X-Men is great.
Yeah.
But comic books are great.
No. Correction. The X-Men animated series, the 90s one?
The 90s one.
It's actually really not that good. But the X-Men Evolution one, apparently, is really...
That one's great.
But like,
that
from what really I remember, I was more interested in that than the original.
The original ones I like, too. Like, I really did.
I actually really like the original, too.
Yeah.
We're
all 50-50. The movies are pretty great.
The movies
are terrible.
Shit,
pretty
dude.
Terrible.
Every one of them except for the last two.
No, First Class was the shit.
Like, I still remember going to. I still remember going to like the premiere for like the first one that came out.
I'm sorry.
When I was a kid, I liked it.
Yeah, yeah.
When I was younger, I liked it. But
I was
watching it again recently.
There was nothing of its kind when you came out. Really,
it wasn't. It really isn't. And then, oh my god. And then I'm gonna throw out a gem here too. Generation X, when that freaking show came out, was actually a decent show.
I watched that.
It was a decent show, but that was another.
It was basically
take on.
About like mutants.
Yeah,
it was the X Men thing.
It was a take.
Oh, okay,
take
okay,
on,
yeah, I remember that.
It was a take on X Men.
It came on like Channel 26. Fuck.
Of all the people that
WGN.
It's pretty much essentially all the other mutants that weren't part of the X or the X Men.
Yeah, I remember that. I used to have a tape
a little
of the X-Men.
But yeah,
but look, Street Sharks. I'm not looking forward to it for many reasons. One, because it looks crappy, but
what about it looks crappy?
It looks crappy, like legit. It looks like it's filmed like the first three. Like it looks crappy.
I'll allow it.
Like
yeah, it does.
But completely looks like shit.
I'll allow it.
But I'm gonna say this: I will watch the trailer though.
And then Sansa,
because you have nothing to lose.
She does not convince me. Like I was like, why the fuck is she in there? Oh yeah, she's Jean Grey. Yeah, she's gonna be sounded the whole
Apocalypse
movie.
Looks like one of the fucking like.
He looks like Ivan Ooze.
No. They posted that, like, so it's out. He
looks
kind
like a fucking villain from like Power Rangers. Like
Ivan Ooze.
Ivan Ooze.
No, I'm just saying like he looks like one.
Ivan Ooze.
I think when we first saw the images like months back,
everybody said he
looked
like.
I said he looked like Ivan Ooze and Wishmaster mixed together.
I really thought that was gonna be the trailer to like the next Power Ranger movie.
Oh my god.
Oh my god,
yeah. Ivan Ooze again? Damn it. Why?
Yeah, why?
Why is everyone like
he was ever in the show?
He had a flute. And he had a flute and he shot freaking
ammo destroyer. The man's in it.
Do you remember
the Black Blade?
When the Green Ranger came in and then he saved the train from falling into the streets because he used his falcon to like.
It was a White Ranger.
It's a Dragon Zord, but okay.
Whatever, bro. I don't go fuck. It's been a while.
The White Yeti Ranger, I remember that.
It does look bad.
Yeah.
But I
don't know.
Should we do like a nostalgia watch?
Who was it that made the first three?
What? Bryan Singer.
Bryan Singer was one of the
Yeah, Bryan Singer. He made the first. Why. He made the first three, and then a different director did first five. Bryan Singer did Days of or Days of Future.
No. He fucked up the first three, and then he tried in Days of Future Past. Mm-hmm. He fucked that up again, and that's where I'm at right now.
Yep.
Yeah, like I said, it totally looks like the first three, and I didn't.
One of the things that I read that it was like really interesting to see was that.
Sansa?
No.
Oh wait.
Like all the other movies have kind of like taken place in some like people against mutants. It's always been humanity against mutants, and it's always been this whole we're looking for a place to call home and this and that. But Apocalypse seems to be like the first X-Men movie that doesn't take that at all.
No, I don't think it does.
We're all united to beat this thing because humans, as much as we realize, that thing is going to destroy everyone.
Steven.
Well, he's also immortal.
Blade 3.
Yeah, so what?
Apocalypse like,
it's the same thing.
Apocalypse is also immortal. That's what I'm saying. He's also immortal. So
was Dracula in Blade 3. And all of them
came back. Dracula technically wasn't immortal.
Oh, he came back. He was the father of everybody.
Because he could like, but he was still not cool.
He was walking out in the daytime. Yes, he was.
All you gotta do.
Yes, he was walking out in the daytime. There's a scene where everybody's walking all fast. He's walking really, really slow.
I'll tell you how to kill Dracula, right? I'll tell you how to kill Dracula. Just throw a bunch of boomerangs a bunch of crosses the whole time. I'm bringing up what the fuck is it? The original Castlevania, by the way. Just throw a bunch of those throw a bunch of the crosses, wait for them to reappear, and just throw the fire every time, and then he's dead. You can kill him in like 5 minutes.
Fire and crossbows.
Yeah, apparently.
But then crosses. Also Jennifer Lawrence being Mystique, like she's not Mystique. She's just
Jennifer Lawrence. Oh, hold on, though. Jennifer Lawrence in that one scene in the trailer where she's like, it's like, we don't know how to control our powers. Like, don't. We're fucking war. I was like, fuck yeah, I want to see that.
No, I'm saying like, she's not Mystique. She's Jennifer Lawrence playing Mystique as Jennifer Lawrence. Like, she's not blue. She's never blue.
Yeah,
needs to be blue.
She's rarely blue. That's not Mystique.
What I thought was kind
of
weird.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, it's like Mystique was never something else outside of herself because she's saying she hated, what was it in the first three movies?
Yeah, Rebecca Romijn actually stayed blue.
And when she's like,
it's people like you.
People like you that made me hate who I was. But then she likes who she is, so that's why she's always blue.
And by the way, she doesn't become green or else she would die.
You're turning the hue down.
Which I think is great.
Wait, did Lalo ever see?
Maybe, I don't know.
What I also think is, one, there's another thing I actually like. I actually do like what they're bringing up in a lot of the Marvel cinematics is the superhero law that they actually have out, which is essentially what Civil War is mainly about. But they've done it in the X-Men one too, which was actually pretty great. But
yeah, but it never
causing the conflict of like that. That's actually a big thing though. That's always mentioned in every single Marvel movie as well. Just that main law.
So now
that's what I'm saying, like that Apocalypse is so different and so far removed from it because this one's like that has nothing to do with what the story's gonna be about.
Doesn't.
It's literally like this bigger character, which is like what the
Ivan News.
What the Fantastic Four movie should have been was like Galactus and this big thing.
Yes.
Hold on, guys. Galactus, that cloud is going to kill
giant
us.
Cloud, guys. But you got to remember, guys.
But
regardless of what happens, we already know Apocalypse doesn't win because they showed at the end of First Class or the last one that came out that they're already in the Xavier's Institute.
Yeah.
And it was in current time, so we already know.
I don't think that's the point, though. I don't think the point is to know what happens.
No. The point I'm is just to saying see the ending. Happen. The ending is definitely going to be more of like, okay, it's expected. Versus,
no.
Do you expect the ending and First Class to be what it was and the same thing for the last one?
Well, yeah, because essentially, when you really think about it, you already knew those endings.
Okay, no, but did you think that Magneto was going to be the one to cause the bullet to deflect and cause, you know,
but that's what I'm saying. Like, you're going to essentially run into the same thing in Apocalypse because
he goes paralyzed.
Things are going to be different.
He's get paralyzed in weird ways.
But
man,
yeah, but it's not just that. It's he went back in time, sort of, and he still managed to get himself shot. Like,
well,
he didn't go back in time.
But he managed to still fuck that up. Like, yeah, he wasn't able to tell like Wolverine, like, come on, bro, help me out. Like, nah. How do you fuck that up?
it's just the fact that the way they make most of those movies is just retelling.
Shit.
Majority of the time, it's never canon to the actual comic books.
That's fine. I'm totally okay with that.
Yeah, which is fine.
It's like,
I'm just being logical and kind
of. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know you are. That's why you're just being a dick. But still,
you got it.
Yeah,
and like I said, I'm fine with them just taking the source material and making something out of it, as long as it's not huge departure from the original material.
But the fact is, when they do their own writing, it's still terrible.
I think I've already.
It is still terrible.
Okay, let's do this, Steven. You think the movie is going to be all right? Promising?
No.
I think it's promising, definitely.
Okay. So, movie comes out in May. We can save this part of the cast, and then we can edit it If he's like, no, I never said that. I'll never deny it.
Because even when we went to watch, I was the one that hated Days of Future Past the most. I remember Cornell being like, oh, that wasn't too bad.
No, I said it was entertaining. I said it was pretty cool. Yeah, it was entertaining. But I didn't like it as much.
I fucking hated it.
I didn't like it either.
I
saw it after it came out of theaters, and it was terrible.
Well, no, because I remember we all went to go see it, and then like the whole ending happened, and I swear to God, the credits, I was like, are you fucking kidding me?
My thing was, I hated the future stuff. I liked the past stuff.
Yeah.
That's why it felt like two separate movies that were filmed in two separate ways by two separate directors.
Well, no, what I was about it is just the ending pissed me off. Like, so everything that happened the first three.
Hey, you guys see that wash over?
Yeah, they pretty much told you, like, the original ones had never existed. Essentially, it's Star Wars again, but it's supposed to be better.
It's a soft reboot. It's like what happened with Transformers.
Yeah, but exactly. When it's telling you it's not canon, it's...
You just put Matt Wahlberg in it.
No, but that was my problem. And like, I was the one that was most excited about Days of Future Past. And I think I was the one that was most disappointed. I guess because I was the most excited.
Like I do for all X-Men movies, I don't go into expecting much because I know I've been disappointed six times. I still haven't seen the second Wolverine movie.
Better than the first
time. Actually, not bad.
It doesn't even matter.
Okay, my thing too, also about the apocalypse.
It does not matter.
I don't like, and I've said it many times, I don't like OP characters.
Or Ivan
or OP anything. Like, or godlike. And this is like one of those godlike things because he gets beat. So like, how are you godlike but you get beat?
That's why he's godlike, not a god.
He has limits. They have limits.
But same thing, it's like why I don't like Superman. It's why I don't really care for that Superman movie, actually. But
I do.
Yeah, I do. Definitely.
I'm still gonna watch.
I'm gonna watch the Captain America one and be more excited about that.
I'm gonna watch all those movies because one, I want to see if everybody when Heath Ledger
was
Joker, everyone said like it's gonna be shit.
McFly.
No, I want to see Suicide Squad though.
Suicide Squad.
I just
want to
check out how.
Maybe, but the thing is, a lot of the characters that they pick is not what it's supposed to be portrayed as.
Your preview into Jared Leto as a Joker, which I don't get the entire.
I still don't like Will Smith being Floyd Lawton because Floyd Lawton is British.
You're saying a black man can't be British?
Yeah, you're saying a black man can't be Human Torch?
Have you never heard of Idris Elba?
He's not black. That's the thing. Floyd Lawton
is not black.
It's not black.
It don't matter.
Okay. Nick Fury wasn't black.
Actually, he was in the comic books.
Yeah, because they made him.
Yeah, but Floyd Lawton never was African American.
It don't matter, fool. You're one of those people. Like,
yes,
you gotta
be
a purist.
One of those people.
Oh,
not purist of the fact
you're
that
not gonna watch the
comic books.
You're not gonna watch the Wiz because they're all
the
black.
Fucking, Street Fighter movie. Jean-Claude Van Damme can't be Guile.
Yeah,
he's not American.
That was stupid. Yeah. That was stupid too.
Hey, that's true.
I did my own rant on that too. That was terrible.
Fuck that. Tommy can't be a White Ranger because he's the Green Ranger and the Red Ranger and then.
The Black Ranger.
And he came back again as the Green Ranger, but he's White Ranger, and the Zeal Crystals are gone,
and then he became a Red Ranger. Yeah.
But then Zordon's dead, so all the other Power Rangers should be gone? Christians are
exactly. No, Zordon isn't dead, he's hungover.
No, he's dead. Fucking, Android's killed the shit out of him.
Android's
destroyed
him. Android's
like, oh, no, kill him with style. He fucking turned around and fucking...
They wanted him to clean the blade right after.
Actually, it was like a drill. It's like a drill.
Okay, they clean
the drill,
whatever.
I just like OP characters. I am going to see the Batman v Superman because I want to see Batman whoop some ass. But you know it's going to be three guys against the enemy in the end where we got to be a team.
Ben Affleck is Batman.
I don't like it.
For most things, I just got to wait till I see them.
I know,
action.
That's exactly.
Watch Argo and you'll see why.
That's the irony of what you just said.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
You're like, man, Heath Ledger is fucking Joker.
I'm going in as saying it probably was just going to be terrible. But once you actually watch the movie, it's going to shatter expectations. I hope it shatters expectations because I'm going in low.
But how does anyone ever feel about someone playing a different Superman? Or playing Superman, like a different actor? No one's ever like, oh man, I hope this fucking person's good.
Superman, you really can't pick on that.
Here's the thing, though. I never really grew up with the original Superman movies.
Me neither.
So that really wasn't my Superman. Like, I didn't care.
Me neither. I never watched the guy
during the fucking early 2000s, the dude that's the Atom on Arrow, I can't remember his name.
Is it Brendan Ruth? Yeah, he is.
Yeah, that movie was pretty shitty. So
it was
like,
a terrible
God,
movie.
I also don't care. Henry Cavill as Superman. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I might not have liked the movies,
but I do like him,
and I do like the way he acts. And okay, I might not like the movie as a whole, but I like the tone that they use.
I just heard it was kind of slow, and I was like, man, I don't like Superman to begin with. Why don't? Mm. And I I just don't want to watch Superman the indie
There's
movie.
Only one thing I like about Superman. It's Zod. Zod's actually badass. That's the only thing.
Yeah, but then he dies.
They need
me. I don't know why he dies. Like, honestly, I don't know why they kill him. He's supposed to be trapped in like another dimension. Ooh, that is dumb.
They didn't put him in a little window thing.
Exactly. That's what.
Okay, we're good.
That's how he's supposed to live the rest of his life. But I don't know why they just kill him. That's dumb.
Because they had it in the
same
movie.
Same thing with Ganondorf.
What?
Ganon. They sealed him away.
Yeah, but it's
and he came back.
Yeah.
But they killed the shit out of Zod. So I don't
but they kill him.
Well, I mean, they tried doing the same in Twilight Princess.
I mean, they kind of did the same thing in Independence Day, where they killed off all those aliens and told them that they ain't coming back. But we got a trailer today showing us
and
that's something else. So we're going to end the podcast here. We're at time.
Will Smith is dead.
Exactly. Will Smith is going to be dead. Yep. We're going to actually do a separate video on the Independence Day trailer, so make sure you catch that.
Will Smith
we're
is gonna dead.
We also got to make sure that this comes out. Before the
no, don't worry about that. We got
this
shit.
Exactly. Will Smith is dead.
We got this. It's gonna exist or it's going to exist.
Exactly. It's gonna be canon, Christian. It's gonna be canon.
Yeah,
better.
We have this.
Better be
dead. Except a white person is gonna play Cornell. So like,
you're gonna replace me with a white person again.
Got to, man.
We're gonna replace Christian with his brother. You just won't tell the difference. One's gonna be skinnier.
That's like a white person.
Skinnier. He's wearing freaking glasses.
Wax Christian campaign. So if you guys. Subscribe to our page and subscribe to our YouTube channel
and like our Facebook
page, which are going to be linked down below.
And our newsletter.
We have a newsletter we're going to start out. It's going to call the League of Ordinary Newsletters. Make sure you check that shit out so we can get Christian's arms waxed.
Come on, look at that.
Man, look at that.
Also, we could probably donate that shit to Locks of Love.
Christmas sweaters.
Next podcast.
Wearing ugly Christmas sweaters.
Look, and if you're a local band and you want us to do some shit for you, find somebody else. All right. Stephen Widow, this is Christian Gabriel, this is Joshua Graham. I'm Cornell Montgomery. Good night.
Shave Christian. Later, y'all. Shave Christian.